A very good morning and welcome, dear parents and students of the pre-primary, our respected principal, Mrs. Lena Daniel, and our distinguished vice chairman, district superintendent, and manager of Bourbon Boys High School, Reverend Sebastian Ravi Kumar, and my dear colleagues. It is indeed a new experience as we partake in this virtual orientation. Before we get started, to resume our online classes for the new academic year 2021-22. We'll now begin with a praise and worship song. I now call upon Mrs. Deborah Webster to take us through the praise and worship song. Singing and making us feel the presence of God amidst us. May I request the parents to kindly stand as a mark of respect and honor as we play the school song.
Strong in purpose, firm.
Be seated. As we are grateful for a new day in our lives, may I now call upon Mrs. Matilda Juggin to invoke God's blessing.
Let us all look to God in prayer. Our gracious heaven-loving Father, Lord, I thank you for this day that you've given us. Lord, I thank you for this time that you have blessed us with, O Lord. Lord, I ask you to shower your blessing on each one of us, whoever's gathered here together virtually for this orientation program, O Lord. Lord, I ask you to strengthen us, restore us, and inspire us with your love, O Father God Jesus. I ask you to bless and restore each one of us, O Father, Lord Jesus. Lord, be with us, guard us and guide us, O Master. Lord, you are the same yesterday, today and forever, O Lord. Protect us, O Father, God Jesus. Lord, I place all the heads of institution in your care, O Master. Lord, I place all the teachers, non-teaching staff and all the support staff under your care, O Master. Lord, especially I pray for parents, O Father. I surrender all the little children under your care, O Master. Be with them, guard them and guide them, O Lord. When they go out and come in, O Lord, be with them, O Father God Jesus. Cover them under your precious blood, O Master God Jesus. I ask everything in thy holy name, O Master. Amen.
Thank you, Miss Matilda. Today's scripture portion is taken from Psalm 121. I now call upon Mrs. Deborah Webster to take us through the scripture reading.
It's taken from Psalms 121, verses 1 to 10. I will lift up my eyes unto the hills, from whence comes my help. My help comes from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. He will not let your foot to be moved. He who keeps you will not slumber. Behold, he who keeps Israel shall neither slumber nor sleep. The Lord is your keeper. The Lord is your shade on your right hand. The sun shall not strike you by day, nor the moon by night. The Lord will keep you from all evil. He will keep your life. The Lord will keep you going and coming in from now and evermore. Amen. The word of the Lord.
Thank you, Miss Deborah. I now request our principal, Mrs. Lena Daniel, to deliver the welcome speech.
A very good and blessed morning, dear parents and beloved students of Baldwin Boys High School. On behalf of our Honorable Chairman, Bishop N.L. Karkare, and Madam Kamal Karkare, management of Baldwin Boys High School render a heartfelt welcome to each one of you and a special word of welcome to our new parents and students into the Baldwin family. Baldwin Boys High School, founded in 1880, is named after the school's founder and renowned philanthropist, John Baldwin, from Berea, Ohio, USA. The name Baldwin descends from a royal derivation and is of German extraction, meaning bold winner. The school's remarkable odyssey took wings at Alexandra Street, Bangalore, with the steadfast aim to provide schooling for the English-speaking Methodist children. The school faced many hardships like paucity of funds, dwindling strength, and so forth. The initial phase of the school and how the school faced unprecedented challenges marks the school's resolve and strength. Mr. John Baldwin's generous donation of $3,000 resurrected the school. The funds were utilized to acquire land and buildings to fulfill the purpose of propagating quality education. The school has grown from strength to strength, setting new benchmarks with the changing times. The school attributes its success to the unwavering and divine Christian ethos, The well-planned school infrastructure has been expanding to accommodate the ever-growing strength. The school has been fortunate to have qualified and experienced teachers who are known for their persistence and dedication to the noble profession. The school, from humble beginnings, has manifested into a sanctuary of knowledge, second to none with respect to stature and dignity. The school motto is, "The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom." True to our motto, the school has been striving to accomplish a fine balance between ancient morals, ethics, and values, and the constantly changing global demands through character refinement and expansion of knowledge. We are helping to groom a new generation of students to become the leaders of tomorrow with sound moral and ethical value. In the 21st century, Baldwin Boys High School offers a multi-dimensional approach for the holistic enrichment of the students. The school is an arena for the demonstration of multiple intelligences. The school certainly doesn't view education or schooling as a monotonous academic activity. The school's dynamic and futuristic vision has empowered the school to forge new avenues to bridge the gap between theoretical and practical learning. The prestigious institution is an epitome of excellence. Our founder John Baldwin and a host of iconic personalities who elevated the school's legacy and heritage to unparalleled heights will be remembered for their passion, courage, loyalty, service-mindedness, righteousness, and truth. The institution is in a league of its own, and the edifice of the school resonates with quality education and stands as one of the tallest landmarks of academic excellence. At the outset, I wish to express sincere thanks to the parents' fraternity for extending unwavering support during the most daunting times. As principal, I could foresee the challenges and adapt variable strategies. The 2020-2021 academic year proved to be the most challenging yet, as we had no choice but explore the deepest realms of virtual learning. Although the COVID-19 pandemic has brought about unprecedented social, emotional, and psychological changes across the globe, at Baldwin Boys, the uninterrupted transmission of the curriculum happened through the virtual channels. Our school's uncompromising philosophy, based on excellence and commitment, has been driving us to accomplish our goals, objectives, and learning outcomes. The 2020-21 academic year resonated with innovation and creative thinking. The transition from traditional classroom learning to virtual or remote learning has been an enriching experience. On the positive front, the pandemic has revealed limitless possibilities we had not considered before as far as remote learning is concerned. Children are like buds in the garden that needs to be carefully nurtured as they are the future citizens of tomorrow. Providing a good foundation has been our priority. Co-curricular activities can provide students with a lot of interest and involvement. It allows students to explore strengths and talents, building skills that are important for the future. Creating art and craft projects enable children to develop their fine motor skills. Art also allows the child to expand their essential vocabulary. They begin to learn the names of shapes, colors, and materials. We prioritized academics and co-curricular activities. Pre-primary students had inter-class competitions like creative costume, elocution, and were awarded e-certificates for the same. By the grace of our Lord, the investiture ceremony, one of the flagship events of the school, manifested into a solemn event graced by the presence of our Vice Chairman, Reverend Sebastian Ravikumar, as the guest speaker. We celebrated Independence Day, Republic Day, Kannada Rajyotsava, Constitution Day, National Mathematics Day, and Christmas Conclave virtually, which promoted the much-needed unity, harmony, and solidarity across the Baldwin Boys fraternity. I encourage the educators to be available during the working hours and at times even at odd hours to instill confidence, strength, and address grievances of the parents. To assess the process of learning, online tests and exams were conducted periodically. We organized virtual parent-teacher meetings to discuss our students' progress. The virtual staff meetings enabled us to fine-tune the virtual learning tools. We have recreated many of the learning structures that support deep learning. COVID-19 has upended family life in India around the world. School closures, working remote, physical distancing. It's a lot to navigate for anyone, but especially for parents. This pandemic has brought with it new challenges for families across the globe. Nevertheless, as parents, I would like to offer a few suggestions to help you make the most of your child's time off from school while keeping in mind child development and child's reactions to stressful and changing situations. Answer their questions about the pandemic simply and honestly. Reassure your children that you are there for them as they rely on you for physical and emotional safety. Set a schedule for the weekdays and weekends. Ensure your child follows the usual school day, weekend day sleep schedule. It is best to have a regular wake-up time and bedtime. You could also set up safe play dates. By keeping the child active each day, he will be calmer and will sleep better too. As parents, spend at least 20 minutes of your day speaking to them about their day-to-day study. Pray together. You could play or exercise together too. Practice what you preach. Young children are impressionable and will mimic your behavior. So make sure you set a positive example. Help your children use their gadgets and social media in more responsible ways. Do monitor them. School-related information would be only through student portal notice board, broadcast WhatsApp group created by the class teacher, SMSs from the institution. I express heartfelt thanks to the parents' fraternity for the faith and cooperation. We shall relentlessly strive to offer the best holistic education for our students. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am, for those warm words of welcome. It is a pleasure to call upon our distinguished Vice Chairman, District Superintendent and Manager of Baldwin Boys High School, Reverend Sebastian Ravi Kumar, to address the gathering.
Dear friends, let me encourage you this day as we all go through this global crisis of COVID-19. Time and tide waits for none, isn't it? Life continues and we move on. We are human beings and we face difficulties in our lives, we face challenges in our lives, and there are setbacks, but we have to fight through it and come out. These things will not defeat us. Why? The reason is there is something on the inside of us. There is a spirit that fights back. We don't want to give up. We don't want to accept our defeat and stand strong in the testing of the time. Let us be reminded of the fact that God has kept us alive. We are alive and not dead. And we fight till the end. Difficulties, discouragement, dissatisfaction, depression are common to all of us in this law of nature. What makes us strong is resilience. It is the ability to return to the original form after being bent, after being stretched or compressed. COVID-19 has affected all of us in one way or the other. There is unemployment and global economic slowdown in the lockdown. There is stagnation of stock market and consumer activity. Several millions of people were pushed to extreme poverty. At the height of COVID lockdown, more than 160 countries had mandated some form of closures for at least 1.5 billion children and youth. Students' dropout rates have grown. COVID-19's effect on education could be felt for decades to come. Beyond education, children, male and female, are vulnerable to the global rise in food insecurity. This food insecurity and COVID have compounded the impact of fragility, conflict and violence. Medical world is struggling, social life is almost dead, and we go without seeing any development. Children losing parents and parents losing children, oh, the pain is too much. And this is the situation we are facing, unexpected and unfortunate, I would say. There are things that come to stretch you. There are things that come to compress you. There are things that come to bend you. But if you have a spirit within you that fights back and stands strong and gives that fight against the storm, I tell you that nothing is impossible. There is a joyful morning after a sorrowful night. In summer, daylight lasts longer and nighttime is shorter. And in winter, this is other way around. Days are shorter and nights are longer. Nothing remains the same. Everything has to change. And there is an escape route in everything that we see, everything that we go through, everything that we face. There is an escape route. What we need is a mind to discern it, eyes to see it, and a heart to go for it. The mighty oak fought the wind and it broke. But the willow tree bent when it must and it survived. And in life, when you face this challenge, be flexible and don't be rigid, because it is a season. It will soon come to pass. One thing will happen for sure in life, that you learn to live with the killer or you kill the killer. When life is not in order, there is something called taking risk and moving ahead. Because we cannot stay in the same place weeping and cursing. We cannot stay in the same place to see our own destruction. We can't stay in the same place losing all the other opportunities that come our way. We need to bounce back. I need to bounce back. There is a statement in the storyline of this movie called Terminator. When the hero was beaten and losing his flesh, he just looked at the person who was beating him and said, "You know what? I will be back. You know what? I will be back." And after some time, he was back in power. When life puts you down, when life tries to bury you, when the circumstances are not in your favor, you just look at them and say, "You know what? I will be back. I am depressed now. I am down now. I am discouraged now. But you know what? I will be back." That should be our response. I am not camping here. I keep walking, if not at least crawling. But I will not camp here. Good days are ahead of me. Life will not remain the same. I am broken now, but I will bounce back. Difficulties will come, but you will recover. You fall sick, but you recover. You are at loss, but you recover. Resilience is something that you last longer than your difficulties. Resilience is something that you last longer than your challenges. Resilience is something that you last longer than your problems. The very thing that comes to kill you will die, because you are ready now with the spirit inside of you that is ready to give the fight till the end. And I am sure that As we all know, stronger is He who is in you than the one who is in this world. Life doesn't get easier or more forgiving. Instead, we get stronger and more resilient. Mountains will remain the same, tall and mighty. But those who come to climb this mountain should have the spirit to conquer it. You will not get the spirit from the mountains, but you get the spirit from the one who has created these mountains. What you need is a mind to discern, eyes to see, and a heart to go for that. With these beautiful words written by Sophia Loren, I conclude. When I got enough confidence, the stage was gone. When I was sure of losing, I won. When I needed people the most, they left me. When I learned to dry my tears, I found a shoulder to cry on. And while waiting for the light for hours, when I fell asleep, the sun came out. That is life. Filled with ups and downs. As she further writes, no matter what you plan, you never know what life has planned for you. Success introduces you to the world, but failure introduces the world to you. Always be happy. Often when we lose hope and think this is the end, God smiles from above and says, "Relax, sweetheart, it is just a bend, not the end. Relax, sweetheart, it is just a bend, not the end." Thanks for watching. God bless you.
Thank you, sir, for that inspiring speech and trust-building faith and confidence. Moving on next is the self-introduction of class teachers, beginning with classes in order.
Hello everyone, I'm Miss Deborah Webster, a pre-primary teacher for 13 years. Thank you, God bless, stay safe.
Hello everyone, I hope everybody is doing safe. I'm Hemlata and I teach in pre-primary department. Thank you.
Hello everyone, I'm Matilda Jagan, teacher teaching in pre-primary block. I welcome each one of you. Thank you.
Good morning everyone, I'm Mrs. Marikannu Sridhar. I have been a part of the Baldwin family for the past 10 years. I worked mainly in the kindergarten department. I enjoy working among children and I like to constantly update myself to help guide them. Thank you.
I am Mrs. Julian De Silva, a faculty of the pre-primary, and I have served in this esteemed institution for 21 years. Thank you.
Hello everyone. I am Mrs. Suman. I am teaching as the pre-primary teacher for the last 23 years. Thank you. God bless you all.
Hello everybody. I am Selvi Stella Rani. I worked for 7 years at Baldwin Co-Education Extension High School and I have been working for 8 years at Baldwin Boys High School. Thank you and God bless.
I am Landina Benedict and have been working with this wonderful Baldwinian family for the last 17 years. Thank you.
Thank you, teachers, for that self-introduction. Sending out a special welcome to all our new parents, in just a word confined in a nutshell, the word trust, as I would like to abbreviate team working together, R, reaching for our goals, U, understanding situations, S, supportive to successfully achieving our goals, T, together we work with trust and faith to accomplish our achievements. With immense pleasure, on behalf of the faculty of the pre-primary, I welcome each one of you, dear parents, and thank you for entrusting your little hearts and minds in our care. We will endeavor to the best of our ability for your child to build a great future. I would like to share a few rules and regulations that needs to be followed when we resume our online sessions. Over to Ms. Suman.
A parent is a teacher at home, and the teacher is a parent at school, and the child is the center of our universe. Good morning to all the parents. As we step into a new academic year, I would like to welcome you all for the orientation for 2021-2022. A short PowerPoint presentation will follow. Welcome to the online class for the pre-primary 2021-2022. The following are a few guidelines for the smooth running of the online class. A short PowerPoint presentation will be presented. Log in and be ready. The children should log in 10 minutes before the class begin. Prayer time. It will be a time of prayer and a time of chorus singing. Attendance. It is compulsory that all children should attend their online class regularly. Be prepared. Find a comfortable place and free from distraction. Children should be made to sit on a reading desk. Children should be neatly dressed, hair combed, and should look presentable for the online class. Follow-up of classwork and homework. Parents are requested to help and assist the child to complete his classwork and homework regularly on a daily basis. For any inquiries, parents, if you have any doubts or inquiries, kindly bring them to the notice of the respective class teacher. So, parents, I hope these guidelines will be useful for the successful year ahead. Thank you.
Thank you, Ms. Suman. As we move on, we'd now like to show you an activity presentation by Mrs. Marikano.
Good morning, everyone. I would like to extend my warmest wishes to all of you in the beginning of a new academic year. The beginning of something new is always exciting. Here, I am talking about a new academic session, which is the next chapter of your life. It comes with a lot of challenges, and the strategy you make to overcome the challenges depends on you. Being a teacher, I strongly feel each child is unique and gifted. Every child is growing, and the only competition is their previous self. Let them always keep practicing, keep learning, and keep smiling. We have compiled a video of highlights of the past academic year. Sit back and enjoy the video.
Co-curricular and extracurricular activities have equal importance in education to ensure the all-round development of the child. Keeping in line with this, we at Baldwin Boys High School conducted a fully virtual creative costume competition. The purpose of conducting the competition was not only to blend learning with fun, but also to develop the confidence in students by giving them an opportunity to be in the spotlight and speak in front of an audience. The competition proved to be a great learning experience for students and gave them a platform to explore their hidden talents. The students in kindergarten are in a very tender and moldable age. We take great pride in molding them into well-rounded individuals. To see what nimble projects their tender hands can build, we organized a clay modeling activity. This helps the students get better control over their motor skills and tune them to the sense of touch. It also gives them a chance to let their creative side take over. Green-thumbed Baldwinians. Farmers are the backbone of our country. The food we eat goes through a very big process before it reaches our plate. In this activity, we ask the students to think about where the food they eat comes from and gave them a chance to become a farmers themselves. On the occasion of Gandhi Jayanti, students were asked to pick their own task based on the events. This turned to be a wonderful surprise for the students and the teachers alike. We had a variety of showcases including art and craft. Appreciation for English literature is abundant in the Baldwin family. In an attempt to promote English speaking skills in terms of pronunciation, delivery, and voice modulation, and to develop English in its spoken form, we organized an elocution program for the UKG students. Many students orated wonderfully and made this virtual event a success. The 26th of January is more than just a date to every Indian. We celebrate our Republic Day on this date. To honor and celebrate this occasion, we engage the children in an art and craft session. This exercise helped instill in the children a sense of unity and patriotism. Every small milestone is important to build the children's confidence and invoke creativity in them. Over the course of last academic year, we organized a lot of activities which did just that. We made our young prodigies pilots for a day by making them prepare paper planes. It was a joy to see them play with these temporary aerial marvels. Another noteworthy activity was the model aquarium. The students made their own version of an aquarium by populating them with paper and clay models of water animals. We also gave them a project where they made albums which highlighted the difference between wild and domestic animals.
I wish that the year 2021 brings a lot of happiness in your child's life. Stay home,
Stay safe and good luck. Thank you.
Thank you, Miss Mari, for that wonderful display done by the Little Hearts. All good things come to an end, and to showcase that, it's gratitude. I now call upon Miss Selvi Rani to propose the vote of thanks.
On behalf of the pre-primary faculty of Baldwin Boys High School, I take this opportunity to propose the vote of thanks. First of all, my sincere thanks to Almighty God for making today's online orientation a grand success. By His blessings and grace, we are able to make this event what it was. I give a really heartfelt vote of thanks to our special speaker, the Vice Chairman, District Superintendent, Manager of Baldwin Boys High School, Reverend Sebastian Ravikumar, and our principal, Mrs. Lena Daniel, for the opportunity to hear your messages and thoughts. This is definitely encouraging us in our future. I am grateful to Mrs. Gillian De Silva for the efforts towards today's anchoring. It is important that we acknowledge the unconditional love, support and cooperation given by our parents. Thanks to all the parents. It is my privilege to thank my dear colleague teachers for their involvement and contribution, who worked hard to make this online orientation. I also want to thank the people who worked behind the scene, especially the computer teachers and the technical department. I am thankful for having given chance to extend a vote of thanks to everyone on this virtual orientation program. Once again, a very big thanks to all. May God bless you and all the best for the academic year 2021 and 22. Stay home, stay safe.
Thank you, Ms. Selvi. We now come to the end of our orientation program. Stay home, stay safe, and God bless.